Machine learning hasn't really delivered in terms of incredible success in finance as much as it did in image recognition, video compression, speech recognition, because there were like stumbling blocks. A theoretician very much helping that direction to remove those stumbling blocks and having a chance for finance people to enjoy as much success as people in the West Coast have enjoyed using machine learning. The problem of finance is particularly hard. You are dealing with objects that are statistically embedded in a lot of noise, that change all the time because markets are non-stationary in presence of relative scarcity of data. In terms of complexity, dealing with markets, it's much harder than recognizing a cat from a muffin having 500 million images. So a lot of the interesting work is being done and will be done inside of financial institutions. Some of these issues are really profound and deep. I'll give you some examples. Markets are reflexive. The simple act of learning something about the market dynamics and deploying capital to it changes the dynamics of the market itself, creating positive and negative feedback loop, such that over time, noise can become signal, signal can become noise. That's not the case for observing or recognizing cats or distinguishing cats from muffins. Markets have very low signal to noise. No matter what you do, the noise is very dominant, and the best you can hope for is to capture tenuous, elusive relationships and make money out of it. And the other theoretical stumbling block was how do you deal with rare events? And that's something that it's not present in image speech recognition. It was really the challenging point that has prevented a lot of people from enjoying that success I was talking about. Well, the issue is, in aggregate, it's a much safer, you know, endeavor than the one of discretionary trading or systematic trading. Of course, like during Brexit, there are people who may end up having the right model or the right trade for the wrong reason, the right reason, and they're gonna do very well. A machine learning architecture will be very tentative. The error bars will go to the roof, and the machine will say, I don't have enough evidence to make a decision. I'm not gonna just take a punt and try to get lucky. So, in individual instances, like, it could underperform, but in aggregate, it's a much better approach to be much more contemplative in nature and, you know, assessing all the probabilities and being tentative at the regime shifts or whenever there is a data break.